Not everyone will find the one, because of a little thing called gender ratios. Statistically, there are 102 men for every 100 women. Out of every 1,000 people worldwide, there are 504 men and 496 women. Now, it's quite hard to work out how many men and women are on the earth exactly, but my point is that the gender ratios are not equal, and most likely never going to be equal. So this leaves a little dilemma. If we currently have an unequal ratio of men and women and we paired everyone up, there would be some people left just because of population numbers. Now we have a group of people without partners. Also, before you think this is a misogynistic red pill video, I can promise you it's not. Because for a start, some countries have more women than men, like Estonia, and countries with high male populations like Qatar. Now there's another little issue here. LGBT. My arch nemesis. I can't even finish that joke. But it was also a bit of a hiccup in What is Love. But no matter what gender or sexuality, the ratio is unlikely to ever be equal in a 50-50 fashion. This can be affected by cultural surroundings, but it's pretty much the same case all over the world. Basically, with the global gender imbalance, that leaves a group of people who are at the bottom of the attraction scale. Now, attraction can vary from your genetic looks, to your grooming, to your personality and confidence. Now, because statistically these groups are going to exist, it leaves room for subcultures like the red pill. You've probably heard of this as it's from the Matrix but has been adopted by incels. This group of people are unable or struggle to find a partner, so they congregate online to discuss their issues and some advice. With any group, there will be extremists, but this whole group are pretty much extremists. It's losers giving advice to losers. Now, I'm not completely crapping all over them, but I don't personally think anything healthy comes from complaining and whining in front of your screen to strangers online. Oh god, I hope there's no irony there. But anyway, incels are basically the statistic who can't be in a relationship or with a partner, and because of the global statistic, it will always be this way. Even if an incel changes their life and gets out of it, they will just be replaced by another one. This is because there will always be this gap in society and basic human population. Unless everybody committed to a polygamous relationship structure, not a great alternative, then there will always be this group of people. A problem with incels, red pillars or doomers is that they romanticise their suffering. Although I like the film Fight Club, it demonstrates this perfectly. Obviously there will be spoilers ahead. Anyway, Fight Club is about Edward Norton, basically a doomer in a suit. He's a lonely, depressed insomniac who eventually changes his life drastically. Edward Norton is a doomer who unconsciously wants to be a Chad. I genuinely hate this terminology, but let's go with it. And to become a Chad, he unconsciously created Tyler Durden, a confident and masculine guy who does everything Edward wants to. He's anti-materialistic and, I'm quoting this, amazing in bed. Okay, I promise this isn't a review, but just hear me out. Edward was tired of being a materialistic wage slave and decided to regain his masculinity by forming Fight Club under his alter ego Tyler Durden. Edward even treats his insomnia by going to support groups for people with illnesses like testicular cancer. However, he stops going to these and starts going to a Fight Club where men beat each other senseless. This is them gaining back their masculinity. Edward even gets together with Marla Singer, a doomer girl, by unconsciously becoming Tyler Durden and being able to use his confidence to get her. The whole movie is about working class to middle class men abandoning societal norms like corporate materialism and using violence as a metaphorical testosterone injection that makes them feel more masculine. My point is that Edward is a doomer and Tyler is a Chad. Edward is a beta and Tyler is an alpha. Edward wants to be Tyler. And honestly, I think the same can apply to everyone. We can all envision better versions of ourselves. It just takes the guts and motivation to do it. Fight Club is an extreme example, and I'm not saying we should set up literal terrorist groups like Project Mayhem to feel better about ourselves, but it has some strong points. Edward's Chad self Tyler got the girl, obviously not the, correct me if I'm wrong, Stacey's or supermodel types, but Edward's unconscious or subconscious goals were achieved. Now I find the concept of doomer and bloomer interesting, because although I don't personally follow any of this philosophy, I understand what they mean. That's how it relates to the Matrix with the red pill and blue pill. Edward from Fight Club was a blue pill. He just bought stuff for his condo and went to work. Until he took the red pill and became Tyler, and Tyler literally burnt down his condo. He destroyed Edward's wage slave materialism. I think Fight Club's whole message was that there's many Edwards in the world who could be Tylers but never become them, so Fight Club showed it but in a drastic measure. And that's how this relates to incels. I'm not going to give you the virtue signalling of how you can be what you want and how every incel can change their lives, because in reality I don't see how this group will ever disappear. Statistically, it can't. My only issue with them is how they somewhat glorify it. You'll see online communities of doomers or red pill or incels, and honestly think, why are you glorifying your own depression and suffering? You're obviously not happy, and identifying and mixing with these subcultures isn't going to help. Obviously there's empathy and relating involved, but I don't personally see any value in that, especially in the circumstances. Sadly, the population of people in any culture, gender or sexuality isn't going to be equal, because that's impossible when you consider things like mortality, birth and fertility rate that is constantly changing. Just because of the natural gender imbalance doesn't mean that you yourself won't find the one. It just means that you being in a relationship is possibly robbing someone else of a relationship. But then again, humans are self-preserving, so that doesn't matter. Finding the one is just a lover. And like I said in What is Love, my other video, love is mainly just chemicals making you want to mate, except humans are smart enough to use latex and afraid of loneliness enough to commit. Also, I don't really support these philosophy arcs at all, because I don't believe in anything genuinely good comes from thinking this way. Obsession with society and masculinity is an unhealthy mindset to have. I think it's sad that incels will always be a thing, but if 2020 has taught us anything, we're far from utopia. Even if they're struggling, that's no excuse for the anger and hate, the misogyny, the hatred of society, and the constant blaming of others. Okay, so here's what you've all been waiting for. Am I an incel or a hopeless romantic? Of course not! Everyone knows YouTube philosophy channels get all the bitches. Respect to you if you've made it this far. Anyway, there's no such thing as the one. As in, there's not really any such thing as a soulmate. As I've said with gender ratios, we're all just kind of here, doing our thing. It's all just very random. So, even though there might not be a soulmate, that doesn't take any value away from love. And I know what you're gonna say, maybe like how, oh, but love isn't real. So what? It doesn't matter. Let's just shut the fuck up for a sec, yeah? Okay? If you actually fall in love, that almost makes it more valuable, because if you've got a soulmate, then it's just like you've expected it. Like, oh, well, my soulmate's hanging around, so I deserve to fall in love, it's just what's happening. So if you actually do fall in love, you should be more grateful for it and just appreciate how lucky we are to have it. Anyway, you're probably looking at this on your phone in the middle of the night, so good night.